Right, let's turn to David. I just feel like introducing him as a David now, but if you've not listened to the programme before, he's David O'Connell. He's a local chap, lives in Willington, and he's a Christian, but he's also a songwriter. And one of the things he does for us is a fantastic little series called Our Story Behind the Hymn. And each week he takes something that's probably very familiar with you, that you've sung since you were a wee child, and tells you how that hymn came to be. Well, what's he turned his attention to for today? Let's listen and find out.
Sometimes we think we've completely got over some terrible experience we've had, maybe the loss of a loved one. And then something happens to bring it all crashing back. A snatch of song on the radio, an old photo we find at the back of a drawer. The floodgates reopen and that old throb of pain is back. All we want to do is move on with acceptance and hope. But here we are, it seems, back at square one. Today's hymn writer knew all about this kind of experience, the Victorian clergyman George Matheson. He was a brilliant scholar and would have had the world at his feet, but he suffered from an eye disease which left him completely blind by the age of 20. When his fiancée learned that he would lose his sight, she broke off their engagement, and so he lost the love of his life. And it looked as if he would also fail in his ambition to become a church minister. But his sister came to live with him and took care of him, and in the end he became a highly respected and well-known clergyman, even being invited by Queen Victoria to preach at Balmoral. And so life for him, though difficult, went on well for many years. Until one day, his sister, whom he loved so deeply and relied upon for so much, came to say she was leaving him to get married. This was a double blow, not only the loss of his sister, but also the painful reminder of his own fiancée's abandoning him all those years before. He was nosediving into despair, but on the very eve of his sister's marriage, a hymn came to him that has since brought consolation and hope to thousands. Matheson said that it took him only 5 minutes to write, and that he didn't need to correct or rewrite any of it. He described it as a day spring from on high, a gift from God. A hymn of hope that doesn't pull the punches about how tough the journey can be. There may be rain, maybe a deluge, but there's also a rainbow. Let's hear the hymn, O Love, That Wilt Not Let Me Go.
our story behind the hymn for today then. And oh, love that will not let me go. And our thanks to David O'Connell for sharing the story behind that one for us.